Hey, hell, maybe one day I might end up turning into a medium too. I like to be able to do that too. I want to be well rounded in this work, in this life work. So I tell you, man, I tell you. I don't know. I'm at a loss for words, really, but I never feel so useful as when I'm making other people happy by showing them love and compassion. I feel useful at that point. I feel like I've done something good, you know? I remember when I used to be out, going from one pathetic, worthless job to another, doing things I hated, trying to make a living. You know, I remember how much I just hated everything. I hated the world. I hated myself. I was ready to kill myself. I wanted to die. Literally. And no bullshit. I was ready to die. I just wanted to off myself, you know, to get away from that. You know, I just couldn't believe it. I just felt worthless and useless because I wasn't putting my innate skills to work. I'm sitting there working in some store or some office. How am I helping people? Am I really helping the world by helping sell products and stuff like that? Or ringing up purchases, putting shit on the fucking shelf? Hell fucking no, I'm not. That doesn't serve anything. You know, that doesn't serve anything or anyone but people's money interest. Other people's, not mine. And that's a lesson too. You just gotta do what you love. Go within. What I mean by that is calm your mind, look to what you feel at heart. What do you feel you're best at? What do you love to do? What are you really good at? And why? What are you good at and you love? Here's Scout right here, if you can see him. This is Scout. Look within and see what you really love, and then do it regardless of what the world tells you. If the world tells you that business idea will never work, or oh, you'll never be a famous musician, you know, you'll never be a famous rapper, you'll never be a good writer, you know, you just can't listen to that. You move on with what you're doing anyway. A friend of mine named Red is, he and his older brother live with me for quite a bit of time, man. They're a lot younger than me, but anyway, Red has always wanted to be a rapper. And I always told Red when he was living with me, I taught him how to do. I said, look, man, you know, people were telling him, oh, you suck, you're shit, you know, you're terrible, you're never going to be famous. But I told him, you don't listen to that, you move on. Move through that ridicule. Me and Jeremy take ridicule all the time from our families, and families especially. You know, like, they don't believe in this stuff, a lot of them. You know, they think it's a waste of time or we're just chumps. And I don't care what they think. I just do it anyway. I don't care what anyone thinks. I know what's true, and I'm moving ahead with it, doing what I love. And what I love is helping people. And the same thing with Red. Red loves music. Listening to music, writing music, rapping. And I said, Red, move ahead with it. And he's doing it. He's been doing it. Spends all his time promoting his CDs, his music, talking to people, traveling to Atlanta from here, spending time down there, networking with people, you know, performing down there. You know, just, I'm very proud of that young brother, man. I'm very proud of him, you know. And he's going to get there. I feel it. I've seen images in my head. I can see it right now. I see this video in my mind right now of him on BET, this video of one of his songs. I saw an interview in a magazine that someone did with him one time when I was thinking about Red. It was just flashing in my mind. I saw the whole article. I couldn't read every word, but, you know, they were interviewing him. I mean, and I haven't told him about this yet. I mean, I might send him this video or go find him, go talk to him. Anyway, I'm going to leave it at that for now. Jeremy and I are supposed to be getting together in a little while, so I think we're going to do some channeling videos. I'm going to try to. Jeremy's been sick the past few days, so he hasn't felt like doing much of anything. But we'll see what we can do. All right, y'all. Till next time. Peace.